I never thought I would utter these words, but legendary performers Cher, Sir Elton John and Elvis Presley are in the country and in the building here to chat about their upcoming show. Would you please give them a welcome?
Now, which one is which?
I'm just kidding. With this, really?
Now, you guys have just come to the country. Welcome, firstly.
Thank you so much.
From the US. How did you guys end up in the world of impersonation? Cher, let's start with you.
Oh, gosh, I don't even know how I started. I've just always been singing and dancing and just fell into the role.
How do you fall into a role?
I just did one day. I have no real exciting story about it. I was not a Cher fan. But I love Cher.
Oh, wow.
I love Cher. I've grown to love her. And I look at this as a great acting and singing role. What about you, Elton?
I lost 2 record deals in the 80s because I sounded too much like him. So I said, if you can't beat him, join him.
And there's no bigger competition for impersonators than for Elvis. I've heard that people get cosmetic surgery. They really go all the way to become Elvis.
Right.
How far have you gone?
I put on the clothes.
Yeah.
Is that your real hair?
Of course.
Good Lord. Darling, welcome to the show.
Elvis, what makes a top grade Elvis then? Like, for you, was it the singing first that you sounded like him, or...?
My mother was an Elvis fan, so growing up, we watched Elvis movies on television. This was before cable and you know, VHS. When a movie was on, we would watch it, and so after the movie, I would grab an album off the rack, go in the bedroom, and sing with it. I was about 6 years old, so vocally, I trained myself ever since I was a child, because, you know, I was a fan of Elvis, you know, so...
Well, at least you were a fan. I mean, that's a good start. But the thing about Elvis is there's such a broad range of Elvises, if you know what I mean. There's like, sexy young Elvis, and then there's, like, peanut butter Elvis. How did you... Did you get to choose which version of Elvis you wanted to be?
Well, I always liked the 70s era because I grew up in the 70s. I just aged myself.
Oh, wow. But I always
liked the 70s. I liked the style, you know, the bling of it, you know. Yeah. But I love all eras of Elvis. But I think the key to being successful being Elvis Presley is knowing where you fit in that timeline. You know what I mean?
Well, I think you've combined the best, like the 70s bling and like the hot Elvis.
Right.
You've done them both.
Thank you very much.
Well.
He can also fit into the slacks, so that's why.
Yeah, absolutely.
Elton, so have you ever met the real Elton John?
I'm not sure.
There is another Elton John currently in the country.
I heard about that guy. Yeah.
I don't know if you've ever come across this guy. Would you be willing to sit down at a table and have it out?
I might or might not.
Wow, what a scoop.
That's right.
We've interviewed prime ministers at this desk and they're not as hard as you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, he's got a good lawyer.
So are you saying that if you and the other Elton went into a room, it would just turn into, like, a black hole?
I think I could take him.
Oh. Them's fighting words.
Yeah, no.
You really might need that lawyer.
No, there's only one of the real for all of us, I believe.
Absolutely.
And it doesn't get any better than the real thing.
Absolutely.
So, yeah. We're a reasonable facsimile thereof.
you're performing with a whole bunch of other legends. Who else can we see?
I also do Dolly Parton, and I'm not sure.
Didn't Dolly Parton lose in a Dolly Parton impersonator competition?
She did. Absolutely, yeah. So did Kenny Rogers years ago.
You're kidding.
Yeah, they didn't think it was the real Kenny Rogers. They said, you're much fatter than the real one. Yeah, it was horrible. Oh.
Is there a good reason that someone would lose their own impersonation? Like, is it a different thing, being an impersonator, to being the real thing?
Is it different than being the real thing?
Yeah.
What I love about it is that at the end of the night, if you've done a show, you can put it in a box and be yourself and have anonymity. Mm. But I love playing Cher. It's outrageous. I get to wear great costumes, and it's so much fun. She's a great role model for women. She's very empowering.
Yeah. She's fabulous.
I can only speak for myself, but... I'm a New York actor. I'm a guy from New York, I'm American. I put the costume on, and there you have it. Yeah. I play the part, and when it's done, it's done.
It's done.
And we leave it in the dressing room. That's the best part of acting, because I can walk around and no one knows who I am, which is good or bad.
It's good.
Depends who you want to be, I guess. You can catch these absolute legends and other legends at the Palms at Crown in January. For details, head to our website. Would you please thank Cher, Elton, and Elvis.